Welcome, everybody. If there is one key message, the takeaway for you for today, then it is that YAVEON is the solution for batch manufacturing. And believe it or not, this is how we have created the name for this great solution, which is called YAVEON ProBatch. And of course, it's fully embedded in Dynamics NAV and certified from Microsoft for the latest version. Yeah, my name is Andreas, and I'm responsible for our channel sales. And today, Cedric is with me. He's one of our senior consultants and supporting this presentation. All right, so let's get started and have a look first to which are the industries we are that they have built our solution for. And of course, first of all, it's the pharmaceutical industry. So typical customers are customers producing APIs or also are contract manufacturers. We have the chemical industry area where we can talk about hazardous substance and goods management. And also typical needs are filling and decanting or mixing processes. We have the feed and food industry where HA, CCP and also the FDA, the Food Modernization Act are topics to be covered. And of course you also pretty often might produce for department stores where you need certain hierarchies. In the cosmetic area, you will see and I guess like the feature management, which helps you to create, for example, your inky declaration. And in the medtech area, we have the need for the lot as well as for the serial number, as well as for computer validation, like in pharma. So that's the core industries we're focusing and addressing with solution. And to give you some key characteristics, YAVEON ProBatch can be set up by parameterization. It's always available on the latest NAV version, and it's a qualified solution. So what does this mean for you? Well, the first point, parameterization helps you to implement with standard capabilities. So that's a big asset during the implementation as well as for update project. Latest NAV version and certification from Microsoft means that this is helping or assuring your investment, so it's rising your investment security. And we're pharma and medtech ready. I'm coming back to this point a little later more in detail, but we comply with the guidelines like from the FDA or the European Commission in terms of good manufacturing practice. Okay, so let's start with a short overview about the functional areas. And as you can see here, we have a solution which has certain areas and modules we can make use of. And depending a little bit on which requirement, but also which industry you are in, we choose the right set of modules for your implementation. Well, the manufacturing is, of course, for, let's say, classical manufacturing companies, but also in the wholesale area, you might have mixing or filling and decanting processes, which is a simple manufacturing process, so it might also apply in this area. A big topic is quality assurance, and this is, of course, to assure the quality at any time in the process. The typical moments in the process are when products coming in, so goods receipt area, the in-process controls, and then the testing of the final goods. We have a delivery rating, which goes in two directions. One is a classical vendor rating, but you can also measure your own internal performance and rate yourself. The data security area is for pharma and medtech a must-have. So this module, for example, brings the electronic signature, which is a hard requirement from the authorities, but also to be able to set access rights down to single fields. That's also something which is a must-have, whether you use it or not, but you need to have it. The trade module is good for building up customer hierarchies. So like when you have department stores as customers with multiple entities, so a head unit for the purchase contract, and then you might have multiple department stores. but also to manage multiple discounts and also the commissioning of the sales force. The HSM interface is for hazardous substance management. Well, that's typically a topic in the chemical area. And the scale integration is mostly used when you have in-process scales and you want to weigh directly based on your recipe. Then we have certain enhancements in the WMS in the warehouse management area, like for the inventory management, like cross-docking and optimization, also in the picking process by classification in ABC articles. With the load carry management, you are able to manage your containers, which is necessary, for example, also to organize the cleaning processes and also to manage the ownership of the load carriers. This is also something which depends. Sometimes it's your own container, sometimes when you deliver it and when you got it from one of your suppliers, you also have to manage to get it back, etc. Yeah, and finally, we have a mobile solution, which means we have a barcode scanner access where we deliver ready-to-go warehouse dialogues, inclusive the labeling. All right, good. So this was a short overview in what is the functional areas of the solution. And here I would like to hand over to Cedric. Yeah, and as Adam mentioned earlier, if you have questions, please type them into the chat and we will answer them in the end of the session.
Thank you, Andy.
We start with the first slide here. Slide number 7.
Second. Yeah.
Okay, so what we are going to show here is the key functionality in the quality assurance area. And what we will see here is all types of inspection features that we also can put in here, target values and tolerance limits, that we have different inspection methods, that we have customer, vendor, item, and item group specific test plans, that we also can do the sample management and handling of the test equipment. So we start with the purchase order and then we will go over to the test plan.
Okay, thank you Andy for the introduction. And I prepared a purchase order for you now. Here it's just a quantity, that's fine. And here we put in our lot number. So I said, assign lot number, please, say OK. And I post my purchase order. But no, I don't want to do that. And what happened now? I go here to our YAVEON ProBatch, and we have here our quality insurance. And we created automatically an quality insurance. You can have now your inspection order, and it's completely automatically. Here you have two possibilities to put in your values. It's, for example, one time you can do it in this way. You can sign in all the values here, or for example, you can directly put your values in here. Depends what you prefer. I use this way, and I said, okay, I would like to put in all the values. If you can use a target. Oh, I'm sorry. Was the wrong line. You had to choose the right one. So, and the inspection feature is 1,000. Okay, and when I say I close it, you can find here the inspection order is finished. And I can say please finish my inspection order. Say, yes, okay. And your inspection order is now changed. And you can go to the next steps. And you can search here for your item tracking and go to the item tracking info and search here for your item you have already put in. So here's a lot number we choose, this one, 34. And here you have your status of your lot. So actual, your lot is blocked, but your status is ready to release. So what can you do with your quality insurance? You can check your items, you can check your lots, you also can check your objects. If you would like to control everything you're producing, you can use it. You can use it when you buy something, or you can also use it when you would like to produce or you would like to send something. So it doesn't matter where you can use it in the system or in the process. There are different ways where you can use it. And finally, you have your part where you had to release your lot. Here, now I can say, okay, I would like to release mine. Oops. I should write like that. And I said, okay, I would like to post it, and we can see what happens next. Here, it comes a warning with the electronic signature necessary. You can say, okay, what's that? I'm not allowed to do that. It's easy to have somebody else had to give me the okay to do that that step. And what that is, the next slide on my PowerPoint, and Andy can show it.
All right, so yeah, when we talk about the electronic signature and item tracking, there is some key functionality here as well. So we have the rule-based setup, which means that we can have an electronic signature by certain events or also by an ad hoc request. The flexible number of signees means that most times it's a 4i principle, but you can also have more than two people to be requested for a signature. And then in the area of definition of password restrictions, this is mainly to fulfill specific guidelines according certain password rules coming from the FDA or other authorities. Okay, can you click one more? Yeah, thanks. Then the key functionality in the item tracking area, that's of course mainly the pedigree to the vendor as well as the customer side. So no matter whether you start with the raw material or the finished product, you get an overview in a few clicks. And it's also about restrictions of status changes, because that's a critical process and you want to assure that this only applies if it's really an approved change. So we'll start here with the request to release a lot, then we will see how we can handle this request, and as a result, the new lot status and also the pedigree of the certain product.
Okay, thanks. Now I can say, okay, I would like to request this one. You can say, okay, I can sign something in, I can write something, I can say, please release, and for be polite, say thanks. Yeah? And now when I say OK, you see here it's requested. You get a message. It looks a little bit different. I go in here, go to my electronic signature, and before I show you how it looks like, I show you the base, how to use. So everybody who is able to use Excel can also handle our rules here. You can just say, okay, you have an area with the item tracking data, you want to change, to modify your status, and the actual status is blocked or something else, and you would like to put in a new one, then there should be an action, and let's please send a message to, in this case, to myself. You can use a different or a second person or third, doesn't matter how many people in there. That's just a short example. Of course, you can use some this rule for unpurchased order, or if you have a sales order or anything like that, you can say, please send it to somebody else who had to sign it, and that you have a full overview and control who is able or who sent, for example, a purchase order or a sales order. So it's my outbox. My outbox looks like that. It's open. You see, okay, at what time you all the time to the timestamp. I send it, and if you get it, it looks like that. So you have the possibility to directly sign, or you said, okay, I would like to see what I had to sign. So here you directly find an overview. You see the line which is interesting is marked, and you can see, okay, here it's requested. It's here 100 kilograms. You would like to change my status to release, and you can see everything what you had to do. If you also want to see the comments, you have the possibility here. You can see everything and say, okay, that's fine. You can say, okay, I would like to sign it. Or, of course, if you want, you also can say no. You can put a password in. In my case here, it's my Windows password, but you also can use another one. Depends on you. You can say here, for example, put a comment in, and then, okay, I would like to sign it. Now, here you can't see it anymore. In my outbox here, it's written and signed. And if I go back now to my item tracking, here you can see the status to signed. And now I have the possibility to post that. Yeah. So it's an easy process. You can use all steps you need, all your hierarchy, and you have also a process how or who is allowed to do something. So now, if you would like to control, for example, what happens with my lot, you can go here, for example, to the item tracking and see directly your lot. But I have another overview I prefer. So it's an inventory summary. You have the inventory summary. You see the traffic lights directly. Here you see the lot. If the lot is blocked, then here, for example, you see it's in green. Here I say you can directly see with one view which location code is it, which lot number, which status. You see the quantity of the lot and the quantity of all items, and you can see all features to one lot. And now, go from here to your item tracking, and you see, okay, you have a purchase order, where you can get your lot. You can see which source it's coming from, at what time it is and who booked it, see the quantity, and you see the status of your lot, and here, for of course, your lot number. The same for every item and every lot. And if you put all lots together, you have a production order, and you created from these five lots, you create one new one. So that's your finished production order, the 2000 from the product 20014, and you can see here your document number. You see again at what time it was, and finally see again the status of your lot. Of course, you also can see if it's a sales order, who it is going to. So if you want to control who gets a lot, you can get it with one click. You can just go in and can see, just give me all the report, I can print it. Let's open, and you can directly see what happens with my lot. So it's all the time fully controlled. You can get all the information to one lot, all your changes of your status, or your guarantee or stuff like that. It's booked on your lot, and you can see it with just one click or two clicks. It's next step is again with Andy, and I show you the next slide. It just takes a second.
All right. So. Okay, one more click. Yep. Right, perfect. Well, when we go over to the manufacturing area, and in specific here, we're going to show some feature calculation. Let me start with what's the key functionality in the manufacturing area. We have combined the routing and the bill of material in one document, which makes the handling in the daily work life much, much easier. We have lot-specific criteria, so for example, you can choose single lot and not to mix different lots from raw material. We have the formula management with automated calculation. So for example, if you change the quantity of the base recipe from 500 to 700, then you can recalculate it with the features. And we have subcontractor handling in the solution, and we have filling and decanting in the solution here. So what we're going to show here is the process from the production order and then finding and choose the right lots based on the features.
Okay. Well, then I can close the slide. Just for you, as information, it's we just have a few highlights of our solution for batch. Here's a short overview of what is also in here. So now we go back and we go here in. It's our production order planning. It's an overview with all production order. There's a graph, for example, here I put in for the state one production order, and you see the capacities and yeah, all the components, if they are available or not. You can see here with just one view. So now we go to our production order. Our production order is in here, and we have the possibility to go in and have a look for our components. Here we have the components. These two have active ingredients, and we just put in features. With that OK for this production, we need features, and we have a lower tolerance limit and an upper tolerance limit. So our solution is able to find now the lots with these values. So if you would like to get a special value, you can put in here your limits, and the system just shows you these ones. So you can get a filter. I've already done that, so I can go to the next step, and this step you can find here. I go to the feature-based item tracking assignment. What a beautiful name. So what's here? You can see your production order and your item number. And you can see here, for example, your features of the line. Here, you can find your actual value, what you have. How do you get this value? You have components. For example, here I can click it. I say, okay, this one is here. And I would like to see my item tracking. I have two different lots. They are in the values we already set. And now I can say which quantity I choose. So if I put in here, for example, 0.3, here on top, you can see how your actual value is changing. So if I put in here, for example, my 415, you can get these values. So you can choose which lots you are using, which lots you would like to use. You can go all the time, of course. You can go back. Okay, now I don't want to have that. You can choose the next one and say, okay, I have a look here. Here you have just this one lot with the values you need. So I just go back to my overview, and you can say, that's fine. I have now choose my lots, and you have a lot you would like to produce. And now you can create a picking list where you can get your items, your special lots you need, and can start with your production. So I just go back. And it's now like you are normally used to do that. Just go in, choose your, or put in your picking list. And what you have already seen, if I now go to my components, there's already a lot number. A lot numbers is saved, what we have chosen, and yeah, we can just put in the other lots because the rest is already done. So now I just would like to go back to my overview, and yeah, I give up to the presentation, and Andy can start with the next part, the key functionalities, and now Andy, you can.
Yeah, for the functional ports, this have been the slides. May you switch back the moderator to me again, then I'm sharing my screen again. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the regulation. So we have in pharma and medical technology certain things to perform for the readiness. Well, let's start with where is this coming from. There we have law and guidelines. Just to name two examples, we have the US Food and Drug Administration and we have the European Commission on a higher level, but of course there is always local authorities on country level as well. So that's the law we have to fulfill either for if you produce in this country or region or if you export to a certain region. So for example, if you produce in Germany, want to export to US, then you also have to fulfill the FDA guidelines. And then there is guidelines like from the GAMP or the Pharmaceutical Inspection Corporation scheme where they give interpretations and help how to manage all this process of computer validation in the most efficient way. So this requires certain things, and the first thing is that it requires that the organization where the solution comes from is ready. Though in this case this is YAVEON, and it requires that we have educated professionals and we have a quality management system. Of course we fulfill both, which we state out in a supplier questionnaire, and yeah, we have passed all audits successfully so far, and we get plenty of audits each year because all customers have to give us a personal or at least a postal audit. Yeah, let's talk about solution readiness. We have a developer guideline how we assure and manage that the development of the solution is done always in the same way and of course also documented with all the changes, which we state out in a letter of conformity where we match the requirements from the 13 guidelines to our solution capabilities and how we fulfill and solve those. And finally, we have a validation toolkit that helps you during the implementation phase to make the implementation as, yeah, let's say, most efficient as possible for you, consisting out of a business process master list with about 150 standard processes. And based on that, with the same process number and names, we have the user requirement specification and the functional specification. The whole package is about 4,000 pages, so that's quite a heavy a piece of work. And then we bring also questionnaires, like for example for the risk analysis 1-2-3, and SOPs, so standard operating procedures for the computer system validation. So due to this set, this should give you an impression what we have done on our company side as well as solution side and for you during the implementation to make this possible and most convenient for you. Okay, how about availability? Well, YAVEON and our partners, we're covering quite a good part of the regions in Americas and in Europe, a little bit of Asia. And so all in all, we have about 20 countries covered by YAVEON and reselling partners. So wherever you are, I'm pretty convinced that we have a partner next to you. Okay, let's go for the key takeaways from today. I'm from YAVEON ProBatch, based on Dynamics NAV. It's an embedded solution. So we have talked about our industry focus. It's best for pharmaceuticals, chemicals, feed and food, cosmetics, and medtech. We did talk about the regulations, that we comply with the regulations which are required or requested for those industries. We did see a piece of the functional coverage. Of course, today we have seen just some examples. There is lots of more functionality. So to give you an idea, the full or the training of the full solution takes 5 days usually. So you can imagine that this today was just a little impression, and there is much more things to see and to learn. We did talk about the global availability. So if this solution is from interest for you, we have quite a good network covering about 20 countries. So we're very close by if you have or if you think that this solution might be from deeper interest for you. Okay, good. So this is the moment where we are open to answer your questions, or of course be glad to discuss if there's any topics you have already raised or you want to drop in the chat. Adam, is there any questions we have already, or
Well, it looks like I think people are collecting their thoughts. So let's give people a minute or two to see if they have any questions that they want to submit.
Yeah, we do so. Thank you.
Okay, it looks like we actually do have one that came in. The first question is, who is responsible for the validation, YAVEON or the client?
Yeah, well, this is, in the end, responsible is the client, because he needs to hit the local requirements and he needs to manage when he gets an inspection by the authorities or an audit by one of his customers. But we make it as easy as possible with the tool set and the templates we bring with the solution.
Perfect, thank you. Another person is asking, how about the cloud?
Yeah, the cloud is really a big topic. Of course, I think everybody who's in the call is seeing what Microsoft is doing, and cloud is, of course, the key pillar of the future of Microsoft. So the very good news is that Microsoft is offering all options at the same time. So we still have the on-premise option, and we still have already certain cloud options. So, of course, our solution is cloud ready, so we can have it, let's say, on an hosting environment with local hosting partners. Our recommendation is to use Microsoft Azure, the Microsoft Cloud, in a single tenant installation. Those options are available for subscription as well as classical licensing, where you buy the license. And the next big thing, which is already in progress, is Dynamics 365. And Microsoft started here with financials, but we will see that financials will also grow and end up in so-called Financials Plus, where the full NAV functionality will be available. Nevertheless, this will take a little time until we have the full functionality on the one hand side, but also the full country availability. And this will be a subscription-only model then. So yes, we have certain areas or certain opportunities how we can handle cloud requirements. And we're having, as well as on the license, but also on the technical side.
Great, thank you. Someone's asking how does your reseller program work?
Okay, thank you. Well, It's somewhat simple. So in Germany and Switzerland, we do the project ourselves, and in all other countries, we are having reselling partners. The reselling partners, doing mainly or coming out mainly out of the existing NAV partner landscape, so they already are used to NAV, and then we agree that they keep the customer contact, they market and deliver our solution to their local region, and we support as ISV on the one hand side, of course, with the solution itself, but also with support in sales, marketing, and operations to a certain extent. So we help to get the people trained, and we help in certain questions during or after training and during customer implementations. So that's basically the reseller model we have. So we have a good mix of practical experience of the projects we do as YAVEON ourselves in Germany and Switzerland, and can transfer this to the partners in the other countries.
Perfect, thank you. Let's just see if anybody else has any more questions. And remember, you can type them into the Q&A box on the right-hand side of your screen, and Andy will be glad to answer them. But if you don't have any questions right now, Andy's email address and his other contact information is right on the screen, so you can always feel free to contact him after the event.
Right. Well, maybe while we're waiting for other questions, we have on our website, yaveon.com, fact sheets, reference stories, and also the events where we will be present and exhibiting. So, if you'd like to discuss more details besides what you find online, please give me an email or send me an email or give me a call. And I'm glad to go for more details. Next event to meet YAVEON would be next week, Directions Asia, where we are exhibiting in Bangkok, but also the Inspire in Washington. And then in autumn, we have Directions US and Directions Europe, where we are present.
Excellent. Thank you, Andy. So why don't we end there? And I want to thank Andy and Cedric for presenting today. That was great. Once again, thank you everyone for attending.
Thanks a lot. Have a good day.
Thanks. Bye-bye, everyone.